In this video, we will be showing you how to get started with Squish for Qt on Mac. This tutorial assumes that you have already installed Squish on your machine. First, you navigate to the install directory of Squish and start the Squish IDE binary. Once the IDE is up and running, you are greeted by the welcome screen. From here, we will show you how to create your first test suite and how to record and replay your tests. For that, click on File, New Test Suite, and that brings you to the test suite creation dialog. You may get asked that you need to grant permission to the security and privacy preferences for Squish IDE. To do that, follow the instructions by clicking on Open System Preferences, clicking on the lock, and then clicking on the plus. And then go to where Squish IDE is in your installation folder, and then click on Open. And then we can close the preference dialog. Now you can enter in the name for the test suite and the location it should be saved in. So let's do that now. Our test suite will be called suite_squish_example and will be saved in the user folder. Click on Next to proceed in the creation. On this page, you will be selecting the GUI tooltip of the application that should be tested in the test suite. In this case, that is Qt. Next, you select the script language that your test suite will be written in. We will select Python in this tutorial. For the final step, you can select the application that should be associated with the test suite. At this moment, there are no registered AUTs. Clicking on the Browse button opens a dialog that we use to navigate to the location of the executable of the application that should be tested. I will use the address book example from the Squish package. Clicking on Finish after that creates the test suite. Now we can create our first test case. You can do that by a File, New Test Case, or click on the icon next to the Test Case section in the Solution Explorer on the left-hand side. This creates a new entry in the list and allows us to give it a name. We will name this test case on the example and then click on Finish. In order to see the code, we double click on test.py in the test case resources section. To record a test case, you click on the red button next to the selected test case in the test case list. This starts the application, and in the upper right corner of the screen, you should be able to see the control bar. You can now record various interactions with the application. When you are done, click on the Stop Recording button. This brings you back to the IDE editor and shows you the recorded code. With the green play button next to the test case and the test case list, you can start the test case. And once the test case is finished executing, you can see the results of that in the result view below the editor. That is the end of our tutorial. We hope you find it helpful and thank you for watching.